The Bible is the centerpiece of our faith, yet many people debate its accuracy and if it can really be taken literally. John Michael Stubbins is with us today. He's with Prelude Publishing. They're challenging men to take a 30-day challenge to make the Bible a central part of their life. And John, it's good to have you back.
Oh, good to see you, Bob. Thanks for having me.
The Bible, does it really, I mean, there are all of these interpretations of the Bible. Some of them go back to the original text and bring it forward. Others have interpreted those things. Does the Bible really mean what it says? Can we take it literally?
You know, I just take it literally by a leap of faith.
Yeah.
Okay.
One of the things it teaches us.
Yeah, yeah. I that's kind of back to that childhood faith thing.
Mm-hmm.
I just, you either believe or you don't.
Right.
It comes and down to that simple of a choice. Yep. And if you choose to believe, you believe all of it.
Mm-hmm.
And so, yeah, I do. I mean, I take it literally, but I also understand that I'm not a Bible scholar, mm-hmm. never professed to be. And so I trust on conversations that I have, I'll ask questions.
Mm-hmm.
I'll say, what does this mean, pastor or minister? I'm inquisitive about these kinds of things. So I just ask questions, and I trust that God will give me the right answer.
I mean, you've got a Prelude Publishing is now has the First Hour for Men, and it's a 30-day challenge.
Yes, sir.
To really get in. You say by the end of this challenge, you will have gone through the New Testament.
The entire New Testament. And you'll end up reading four pages back and front, so it's about 8 pages of reading per day. This book, really, it's a workbook more than a book.
Right.
Exactly. Yeah.
It's a guide.
It's literally labeled day 1 through 30, and each day there's a list of tasks that you need to complete. One of those tasks is obviously spending time with the Lord, praying, giving your first fruits, putting on your armor, you know, things like that, spending time with your family, but also time in the Word. And you're going to read a certain amount each day as part of your exercises to get through day 1 through 30.
Morning prayers, 30 minutes, Bible reading, 30 minutes, and it gives you the scriptures to be reading.
Sure.
And then physically work out to keep the temple of the Holy Spirit.
Spend time with your family.
Keep the Bible. And then it says the actions, return home, anticipating spending time with your children wife. And so it does get you into a 30-day discipline.
There's a structure, right? So
guarantees?
Oh, I guarantee you one thing.
Yeah.
God shows up. And let me just say one other thing. The way that structure is broken down, remember, when we say give your first fruits, we're asking you to give an hour. Okay? Yeah. We're not asking you to give 3, 4, 5. A lot of people say, well, I've got commitments. I got to get to work. I got to do this. I got to do that. We're asking you to get up an hour earlier for 30 days.
Yeah.
At the end of that 30 days, if nothing's changed, well, then you go back to your old way.
If somebody promised me a brand new car, if I got up an hour early every day for 30 days, I'd do it.
That's right.
They're going to give me something.
Yes.
You got some guarantees in this. But it takes discipline.
Yeah, my guarantee is that God shows up and that it's powerful.